So it's 6 p.m. on the clock. As usual, I close my small black box of codes and mails. Give a big huge bye to my colleagues as if I'm leaving them forever. Yes, that feeling to reach home, live on your semi-cozy, semi-messy bed is euphoric. So I just ventured out from the office building and gods were not in favor of me. And they started their tussle. The same old Zeus versus Hades. And nature roared, the nature cried. Rainfall stuck. But today I was in a good mood. I don't know why. And today I thought to walk back home rather than going in that big red chana box filled with humans and moving jail. Of course, the bus. So the roads were all muddy since it was raining. Birds fluttering from one corner to another, dogs are grumpy, cats are scary, petrified animals. Horns honking, bikes whizzing, blah blah everywhere, traffic jams jamming, RJ Madhuri yelling from an auto wala. Two open vendors, food, magazine, newspaper, samosa walas, all running for shelter. So, eventually I took a detour into a silent lane, a narrow alley, a shortcut I know to reach my home quick. When I saw a little boy making paper boats, some small, some big, and some with pirate flags, and watch every boat reach its destination, the gutter. Where boats fell off from a huge waterfall into a valley of wonders. A sense of satisfaction surging in him. So, in few steps, there were a bunch of school kids in their blue shorts and white shirt playing football in a small rocky ground. Slipping, gliding, and flying, celebrating, scolding, running all over, joyous like never. Being far away from any worldly concerns, enjoying every moment, pressing every epoch, the feeling of felicity filling up. So, further on the corner of that street, a small tea shop with tin shed protruding outside, water drops drifting, with a boy and a girl holding hands beneath, looking into each other's eyes, one hand holding each other and one of course a teacup. Every sip bringing closeness, a bond binding over a beverage, and the brisk of brink of dawn. The romanticism rejuvenates. Moving further, so a quick turn to enter a more calmer passage, a somewhat kacha road, broken barricades, walls worn off, and a house I see, with a cracked roof, rainwater drifting into their homes, a rusted iron bucket to compile the rainwater, a family buzzing inside, mother yelling to clean the floor, as she was busy making evening snacks for her husband, her kids, a happy family I'm so sure. Struggling, yet smiling, delighted, and very pleased. So at last, I am nearing my home now. A turn here and a turn there. To see my father, home early today, awaiting for me in this vengeful weather. Glancing over his watch every second, wondering where am I stuck? When will he reach? Where is he? When he knows I am safe and I will be home, a father is always a father. So, suddenly a flash of these events comes clashing into my mind vividly, and I wonder, the chaos is there everywhere, unavoidably. A soulful kid with his pirate boat, boys speaking football with full passion, a content couple closing into each other, a family full of festive fervor, and my loving father waiting forever. From a kid to a boy to a couple to a family, isn't this the whole life is all about? Isn't this why we are here? Finding happiness in small, petty things and sobbing over silly things. Isn't this the whole parallelism of existence? Isn't the kid me or one of the boys me? And how can I forget my first love when I was 15? And isn't the family, the festivities, hullabaloo? And in the end, waiting for a loved ones to be back home in the cocoon of love, the life. So indeed, it wasn't that monotonous that evening.